ABC, John here. Quick video to update you with what I've been doing the last week. It's a bit wide ranging actually, and sort of shows how eclectic taste is, it can be. Playing in the background is Deep Purple's new album, and it's very good. Ignore the fact the cover's not great, because the actual album is as good as they've done for 20 years, in my opinion. It's a double album. I pre-ordered it. I've probably said before that I've always liked, it's Ian Gillan, actually, totally like his voice, and he's now 67. There's a great article in, if you'll just bear with me, there's a great article in Classic Rock magazine about the band, and a picture of Ian Gillan on the front this month. But I could wholeheartedly recommend this to you. And the fact that I pre-ordered it, it was £13.50, and it's a double album. Let me just turn that down. Which is what I'd like to rock out. So that's Deep Purple's new album. That take you back now, 29 years, I think it is, 29 years, something like that. Anyway, my wife and I properly got together in 1984, and you know how it is, you want her to like your records, she wants you to like hers, and this is an album she introduced me to. This is Tracey Thorn's A Distant Shore. There you go, it's got a Students' Union from Leicester Uni sticker on there for £2.90. And the reason I'm showing you that is on Thursday night we went to a book signing in Manchester, which was Tracey Thorn and her Bedsit Disco Queen book, and it was just really entertaining. There was a bit of an interview before, about an hour, talking about her life and music, and she was referencing about long gone bands like Whirlwind, who I remember seeing supporting The Clash a long, long time ago. And anyway, there was a book signing afterwards, so we queued up, got the book signed, and I presented her with not just that, which was my wife's copy, but also presented her with a copy that I bought at the same time. Unfortunately, she was a very nice person, and she was kind enough to sign both, but unfortunately, it did get smudged, but hey, I'm not going to worry about that. And I also took the recent acquisition, which was Tinsel and Lights, the box set, and you can sort of see her face when she saw this. Sort of, she said, "Oh, that's not vinyl, is it?" And I said, "Well, yes, it is actually, Tracy. Sorry about that." And she was just really accommodating and generous. So, and I've shown this picture on Facebook, but I'll just drop it in. It's a photograph I took of my wife and Tracy, and it is a really good photograph, even though I do say so myself. And it's one that you'd quite think that she was. She'd be happy to show her family, not with my wife in, of course, that's just a bit creepy. So hopefully that should just come up here. Right, and the other thing that I really want to talk about, this won't be a long video, is that there's been a lot of, in the VC, people showing cassettes. And back in the day, I never bought cassettes. I used them to tape, I had a few cassette decks taped, things that I wanted off the radio or off albums, and then played them in the car. But I never bought them because I thought I'd rather have the records or the CD subsequently. But recently people have been showing a lot of cassettes on the VC, and it's caused me to go hunting them out. And the reason I love them now is they only cost 10 pence. Or, you know, like for this, for example, I bought this for 10 pence. You can see what it is, it's a classic. Or this, I got this for 10 pence as well. So I did have this Technics cassette deck, which I've had for a long, long time. It's a, I can't even read it, I've not got my glasses on. Turn the light, it's RSB355. Had it a long time, hardly played it, but then I've been using it recently. But then I did spot on eBay a bit of a bargain for £50, and it was, in the day, this particular make were the prints of cassette decks. So this is what I want to show you next. and I'll talk about it once I can get a camera and get over there.
Okay, VC, so here's the setup, my setup, and here it is. This is the Nakamichi Cassette Deck 2. Now, I have said before that I've been working away and spent a lot of time looking on eBay, and I found this in a place called Newbury for £50, and the claim was that it had hardly been played. So I went to see the chap, went on his drive. It was the biggest house I've been in for a hell of a long time, and he told me a little bit of a story about it. He said it was 20 years old, he'd bought it, it was high end, and the reality was that he'd hardly ever played it. He said if it's had 50 hours play, that's maximum. So let's just give it a quick whirl. So we'll just try this. As I said, I bought this recently for... So here we go. So I paid 10 pence for this cassette recently. One of my favourite all-time albums. And now I'm not sure how this is picking up the sound, but it's excellent. And I'm not really at home to these people that say, oh well, it's not as good as a CD or it's not as good as vinyl. Often it isn't if it's been badly treated tape, but when it's been looked after, the sound's excellent. Great separation. And I've not really played with all these buttons yet. I've downloaded the manual, but there's the Dolby noise reduction, etc. So this bit of video, especially for LJ, we've got bank holiday here in the UK. The weather's glorious, so hope you're all doing well, VC. Have a good week and take care.